Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied what are the methods of preparation of alkynes, and now we are going to study about what are the different physical properties of alkyne. So let us start with that. So talking about the first one, that is the lower alkynes, namely that is the first three members of the alkynes are basically gases, and the next eight members are basically liquids, and the higher members are basically solids. So similar to that of the alkenes, as well as in alkanes, the lower members of the alkynes are basically are in a gaseous phase. And talking about the next one, that is except ethyne, all the alkylenes are basically odorless gases. So therefore these are can be odorless gas or can be odorless liquid or solids. So let us talk about the next one, that is alkynes have slightly higher boiling point than the corresponding alkanes and alkenes. The reason behind that is because alkynes form a very strong bond between the other carbon atoms. Talking about the next one, that is alkynes have slightly higher boiling point than compared to that of the corresponding alkanes and alkenes. And talking about the next one, that is the melting point and the boiling point increases with the increase in molecular mass. So this is similar to that of the alkanes and alkenes, in which the higher members or as we move from a lower member to a higher member, obviously the boiling point or the melting point goes on increasing. But it also depends on the branching also. The branching, the branched alkanes as well as the branched alkenes are having the less boiling point or melting point compared to that of the straight chain alkane or alkene. So similarly here also, as the molecular masses increases, the boiling point and the melting point also increases. And talking about the last one, that is they are less dense in water and hence they are very insoluble in water. So therefore these are the hydrocarbons which are not soluble in water, but yes, they can be soluble in organic solvents like benzene and chloroform, etc. So therefore these are basically not soluble in water. So now moving towards the next one, that is what I am going to talk about, that is the bond enthalpy. So in the last chapter, that is in alkenes, we have got to know that the distance between the carbon and carbon-carbon double bond is less than compared to that of a carbon-carbon single bond. So here also, as you know, that we could see that carbon-carbon triple bond is been present between the two carbon atoms, and this is because of the lateral overlapping of the p orbitals of the both the carbon atom, and that is the reason that a weak bond has been formed, and that is basically known as pi bond. So in this case, basically the one among the three, one of the bond would be a sigma bond, while the other one would be other two would be pi bonds, and this pi bond is occurring because of the lateral overlapping of the p orbitals of the carbon atoms. And talking about the bond length, yes, the distance between the carbon, this carbon and this carbon, or when we are talking about the bond length, it is very much smaller than compared to that of the alkene and compared to that of the alkane. And talking about the bond enthalpy, because as you could see that there are basically three bonds, so it is very easy to understand that the number of that is the bond enthalpy that would be required triple than that of the bond enthalpy for carbon and carbon single bond, but it is not so. The reason behind that is because of the pi bonds that are been present, and they are very weak bonds compared to that of the sigma bond, and hence less energy is been required, and it is not that we have to apply the triple the energy or bond enthalpy for carbon-carbon triple bond here. So in this case we have to apply less than, that is suppose if carbon and carbon bond while breaking a sigma bond, we require, suppose the bond enthalpy is suppose H1. So in this case, suppose what will happen is, because triple bond is present, the expected value should be 3 into that of the H1, but it is not so, it will be required less energy. So therefore less energy, therefore less energy has been required, that is less than 3 into delta H1 has been required so as to break the bonds of carbon-carbon triple bond here. So now this was the actually the properties that I wanted to showcase. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and I hope you will subscribe Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.